In this video, a one-handed knot tying technique is demonstrated to form a secure reef knot. The surgeon in this video uses their left hand as a tying hand. The same principles are used if you use your right hand as a tying hand. The pink end of the rope represents the free tying end of the suture, and the green end represents the long needle end of the suture. When the short tying end of the suture is lying away from the surgeon, the first half of the reef knot is started with an index finger tie. The suture is picked up between the thumb and the middle and ring fingers while the left hand is supinated. The hand is then pronated in such a way that the rope is presented upwards by the index finger. The right hand then lays the green long end of the rope over the tip of the left index finger, parallel to the pink rope. The index finger then flexes, pulling the green rope laterally. Once the back of the nail reaches the pink rope, it extends and flicks the pink rope through the loop. Once the pink rope is outside the loop, the middle finger adducts against the index finger to hold the rope and pull it out of the loop. The knot is tightened by pulling both ends at 180 degrees to each other. This straight configuration is referred to as a square knot. The pink end is always pulled in the opposite direction to where it started. The second half of the reef knot is performed with the backhand throw. The pronated left hand picks up the pink rope between the thumb and the index finger, with the radial side of the thumb near the surgeon. The remaining three fingers are placed on top of the rope before the hand is pronated. The right hand then lays the green rope over the left fingers parallel to the pink rope. The middle finger of the left hand flexes, pulling the green rope laterally. The middle finger then extends, flicking the pink rope medially with the back of the nail. As the pink rope is being pulled through the loop, the thumb releases the rope and the ring finger adducts against the middle finger to pull it through. The pink rope is pulled away from the surgeon to where it started, and the green rope towards the surgeon. A reef knot has been completed. So when the short end of the suture is away from the surgeon, it is picked up by the left hand between the thumb and the middle and ring fingers, and then held up by the index finger to start the index finger throw. The green rope is laid over the left index finger parallel to the pink one. Immediately, the green rope is pulled laterally by flexing the index finger while it hooks the back of the nail behind the pink rope. The index finger then extends and pushes the pink rope through the loop. The left middle finger then adducts against the index finger to hold the rope. The knot is then tightened squarely. The backhand throw is then commenced by holding the pink rope between the thumb and the index finger and pronating the hand. The green rope is laid down parallel to the pink one. The middle finger flexes, pulling the green rope laterally while hooking the back of the nail over the pink rope. It is then pulled through the loop formed, with the help of the ring finger adducting against the middle finger. The knot is tightened, forming the reef knot.